Hello everyone, welcome to your very own channel sonisinghphysics. In this video I am going to discuss all the important questions related to radioactivity which is repeatedly asked in your igcse or class 10 examination. Along with each question I will discuss the concept behind it, how and why. So let's see that. Question 1 is, which diagram represents the structure of a neutral atom? And here as you can see there are 4 options. So neutral atoms means in which positive and negative charges are equal. So the answer will be option B. In a radioactive nuclei, stability depends upon number of protons and number of neutrons. If the number of protons and neutrons are equal, then that nucleus will be stable. And if there will be difference in this number, then that nucleus will be unstable. So unstable nucleus used to cause radioactive emission. Third question is, the symbol represents a nucleus of zinc. You can see a zinc symbol over here. Which row gives the numbers of protons and neutrons in this nucleus? So as we see all the options, option A is correct one, because number of protons will be 30 and number of neutrons will be 68 minus 30, that is 38. Fourth question is related to the behavior of alpha and beta particle in an electric field. As per question, the diagram show alpha particles and beta particles passing through an electric field. Which diagram shows the correct path of alpha and beta? So if you look at all the 4 options, then option B looks correct, because alpha is the heavy mass particle and it is positively charged, so it will deflect towards negative plate, and beta is massless fast moving electron negatively charged, so it will move towards positive plate. Beta will deflect higher than alpha particle. So the correct answer will be B. Question 6 is related to half-life of a source. As per the question, a laboratory worker measures the count rate from a radioactive source. He records his result in a table. The average background radiation in the laboratory is 8 counts per second. What is the half-life of the source? So before answering this question, I'll explain to you what is count rate, what is background radiation and what is half-life. Count rate is the number of emission in a given time. It can be in a second, in a minute or in an hour. Background radiation means radiation produced by all the other material apart from radioactive nuclei. So as we know, not only radioactive nuclei, all the substances which are around us, they also emit radiation, and radiation by them is called background radiation. Half-life is the duration in which a radioactive nuclei reduced its mass to half. Now look at the question and we'll answer it. In this table, the time is given in minute and the count rate is given, and we have to see that what is the half-life of this source. So in the beginning, it is 100 count per second, and in 2 minutes, that 100 become 54. So the correct answer for this one will be 2 minutes, because in 2 minutes, the 100 becomes 54 nearby. This is another question related to half-life. Question is, the graph shows how the count rate from a radioactive sample changes with time. What is the half-life of the sample? So if you look at the graph, in the beginning the count rate is 500. So we have to look that in how much time this 500 will become 250. So when you look at the graph carefully, it is in between 100 to 150. So nearby in 120, as per the options, in 120 second, the whole material will be half. This is another type of question related to half-life, and the question is, the graph shows the decay curves of 4 different radioactive isotopes. Which isotope has the largest half-life? So when we compare A, B, C and D, A is having largest half-life whereas D is having least. This is a question related to alpha, beta and gamma radiation, and the question is, the diagram shows a radioactive experiment. When a piece of paper is used as the absorber, the count rate drops to the background count rate. which radiation is the source emitting. So this is the radiation which can be absorbed by paper itself. So the answer will be alpha radiation. When we compare the penetration power of alpha, beta and gamma radiation, alpha is having least penetration power, whereas beta medium and the gamma is the most penetration power. Alpha is having least because it is having heavy mass, so it can be stopped in the nearby distance, whereas beta is fast moving massless electrons. But gamma is just a form of energy, and we say photons, so they can penetrate any material. This question is also related to penetration power of alpha, beta and gamma, and as per the question, the diagram shows the paths of three different types of radiation, X, Y and Z. So which row correctly identifies X, Y and Z? So if you look at the penetration power of X, Y and Z, X reaches till 10 mm of aluminium, Y is stopped at 2 mm of plastic and Z is reaching till 50 mm of lead. So definitely Z is gamma, Y is alpha and X is beta. So the correct answer will be B. This is a question related to beta decay, and as per the question, which equation represents the beta decay of lead 209? And when you look at all the options, the correct option will be option C, because when a beta emission takes place, the atomic mass will be same, which is 209, but atomic number will increase by 1. So the correct option will be option C. Why option A is not correct? Because in option A also, atomic mass is 209 and atomic number is 83. The problem is when you add left side of element in option A, it will be 209 and 81. And whereas right hand elements will be 209 and 83, which is unbalanced equation. In radioactive emission also, the equation should be balanced. So when you see in option C, left side is 82 and 209, whereas in right side also 83 minus 1, 82 and 209. So right, this is option C is the balance equation. This is another question related to beta emission, and the question is, some radioactive nuclei decay to give new nuclei which are also radioactive. Part of a series of decay is shown. How many decays involve the emission of beta particle? So we will look each step correctly. In the beginning, this uranium has 92 proton number and 238 nucleon number, which has been reduced to 90 and 234. So it means here there is an alpha emission. In alpha emission, atomic number will decrease by 2 and the atomic mass will decrease by 4. Then the next is, atomic number became 91 and atomic mass became 234. It means there is an increase of 1 in the proton number. So it means here there is a beta emission. Then the next is uranium 92 and 234. Here also atomic mass is same, that is 234, but atomic number has increased by 1. So again there is a beta emission. So till now there is 2 beta emission. Students, I hope this video will be helpful for you, because I have taken all the possible questions related to radioactivity. If you want something more, you can text me. I will come back to you very soon. Thank you for watching. Please like, share and subscribe to my channel and your very own channel, Sonisinghphysics. Thank you.